starting my broadcast here on my kitchen table, and we're going to move into the kitchen right now, okay? Because it's a lot easier for me to do the laptop here than it is in my kitchen. I just don't like the laptop in the kitchen, y'all. Okay, so come on in. We can you can do a couple different things. We're broadcasting here on Haps, which is a social media app where you can share out. We're sharing out to YouTube. Yeah, it's going up to YouTube, so we can save all those. Going over to Twitch, Twitter, and Facebook business page profile, and my VIP group, and that's my mom's phone. I don't have to answer it, okay? Of course, it has to. That's what happens when you do a live broadcast. Who is that caller? Don't know who that is. All right, she's not going to answer it either. Oh, she did answer it. All right. So anyway, we're going to be making some soup today, and it's really super easy. We're just going to plop, plop fishes into the container and let it cook. It's going to parade all up. It's a delicious soup. If you're into healthy and making your own from scratch, then this is definitely the soup for you. We're doing butternut squash soup because, you know, it's my fave, okay? So let's see. I don't see anybody here. We're going to flip us around. I'm going to show you some tools that we're going to be using and get going, okay? Because I want to have some soup. All right. So the first thing that we're having is butternut. This is a butternut squash, and we're going to be using this one. And you know, I forgot to wash it. We're just going to rinse it under some water. It's been sitting on my countertop for a little bit, but we're just going to give it a little wash. Just put some water on it and wash it down, okay? But we're going to actually cut up. We have a little bit of an old apple, and hopefully this is okay on the inside. I got an onion we're going to be using, some carrots, and with the peels, of course, we're going to be saving our peels for our stockpile to make our own vegetable stock, all right? This is the recipe that we're using right here. Now, I've already made this one several times, and I said add-ins, put nutmeg in here, some pea protein, and use less water. So I have my little notes over here, and also use half the amount of sugar. It calls for 2 tablespoons of brown sugar, but we're going to only do 1 tablespoon of brown sugar in there, okay? Hey there. Hello, Captain Rehab. How are you doing? This is Bryce. That is not Bryce, Captain Rehab. I know you're joking. Actually, Bryce called me last night, so I know it's not you because he's not on any of these social media that I'm on, which is good. All right, so cheers, everybody. Drink some water while we're at it. Before we start, we're going to actually peel some of this stuff up, and I have my tools in front of me. When you purchase $80 or more in the month of April, you get a free gift. And right now, currently, it is either the serrated peeler or the regular peeler, vegetable peeler. All right. Free gift by Pampered Chef. We do have a mystery show going on. For every $25 that you order, you get 1 ticket to win the host rewards. Okay. So we're going to just peel our carrots. And yesterday, we peeled carrots. We could have peeled them all at once and then just left them out. But, you know, I do everything from scratch and I don't prep ahead, which you can prep ahead and peel all your carrots for the whole entire week and you'd be ready to go. But then you wouldn't see me peeling all this. You wouldn't see me how to peel carrots here. So we're just doing it calls for 1 medium carrot, and I have like 2 small, like 1 little itsy bitsy one and a smaller one. So we're just using 2 of them here. All right. Get those off to the side. All right, there we go. That one has that little straggler there. All right, so we got that. We're going to get a knife. All right, now you can either use the coated Santuco knife. I like using either one of these or the stainless steel one. Let's use the stainless steel one because we used this one yesterday. Both of them come with covers. And if, when you're not using them and they're not in a block, make sure you keep your cover on it because it keeps your blade nice and sharp and it protects your fingers also. This thing has a little lip right here so you can pull it up and down. Like if I want it out of my thing, I can pull it up. If I'm pushing it in, I can put my finger it right there. Okay. So that's what that's there for. We're going to cut the tops off of these and the bottoms. All right. And cut that in half so I can just throw it in my blender. We're going to do this all in the blender, y'all. Okay. And my blender, you know, I love doing ice cream in there. Let me see. I'm going to get my garbage bag out that we did the other day yesterday. Okay. So this is your freezer bag. You're just going to get all your stuff and put it in the freezer. You're not going to throw that away because you're going to make some stock with it. Okay. Veggie stock. That way you don't have to pay $2 for the container of vegetable stock. All right. So we got the carrots. Let me put the carrot down. Doesn't matter how you cut it. It's all going to get blended up. We're going to do up a onion. All right. And I only need half the onion. There we go. And with this top, I can actually put the top in my bag also. All right. If you put the peel in your bag, it's going to turn it your stock a little bit darker color. Okay. So I'll just put this in here. It doesn't matter if it's a little bit dark or not. All right. Put that peel in there. The other peels that we're not going to use, we're going to throw those away. And I don't need my onion. And I should put my onion in a bag or in a another container so I don't start crying over here. Okay. So we've got here's our onion. Onion's already done. Half of an onion.
Got it.
Just cut it any which way away. We're going to put that off the side. Now your apple. Now my apple, I can either use a core to get it out, okay? Or I can use my apple wedger, or I could peel it. Since the outside the apple is probably one of the best parts, I'm just going to use this. Let's just use this one, and we're going to slice it right down into this is the apple wedger, okay? We're just going to go right down. There we go. You can even save your apple in your stock if you want it a little bit sweeter also, but I'm not going to save it. I'm going to put that away. Okay, there we go. Got our apple ready to go.
All right, that recipe actually calls for dried apples, but who has dried apples in their house?
I know I don't. All right. The next thing we're going to do is peel up this garlic peel. Now, yes, you can get your knife and put the blade away and hit it on the thing and peel it that way. Or you can get a peeler, garlic peeler, and just roll it with your hands, okay? Your kids can help you do this one. And then, come on out. There it is. It came out. Look at that. There's your garlic, okay? It called for two small garlics, but that's a pretty big one, so we're just going to do one. Next. All right. So we're getting all of our veggies ready to go here. All right. Now we have our butternut squash. The butternut squash has all of its seeds down the bottom here. And we're gonna take the skin off of this one. Now, this is where this peeler, you can use a vegetable peeler, but the better peeler for butternut squash and squashes is a serrated peeler. And you see how the blade has like little jagged lines on there? You can see it better on this one. Take the cover off because the cover does protect you. You can take a good amount of your own skin off on this one. So be very careful on this. All right. Hello, Swift Beats. Hello, Anne. Hello, Knowledge. How y'all doing today? Hello, Sassy Sinead's in the house. I'm just going back scrolling through here. Hello, Cheryl. Captain Rehab's in the house. Oh, my goodness. Water is good for us. Yes, it is. What's the mystery show? A mystery show is where I don't have a host associated with the party. And for every $25, including shipping and tax, you get one ticket to win the host rewards. One time way back in June, July, where we had double rewards, one person won $2,500 worth of Pampered Chef. The average is about a couple hundred dollars, okay? Maybe, $200, $600 of Pampered Chef is what they normally get on a pretty large party. Okay. So everybody needs a good peeler or a good knife, a good mat. You see my mats down here. We do have the mats. I'm trying to get this. I'm doing this all at once. Look at this. You can do it this way, or you can just do it half of it, half the amount there. That would work too. I will not save the peels on my squash though. Okay. That one, this can go. Let's see if I can get it all. I'm doing a good job of doing it all the way down, y'all. Normally I do half and half. All right. So a mystery show is for you that don't want to host a party but want to order and maybe get a chance to win some from some free Pampered Chef. Now you get Pampered Chef dollars on it. You will get at least one item at 60% off whatever you want that's available in the catalog. And you will get a few items at 50% off. And everything else on your order will either be 10% or 30% off, okay? So there's a lot involved in the mystery show, okay? And it's a lot of fun, all right? And for those of you that have every single Pampered Chef item, well, you know what? You can always do some seasonings or get one of those enrichables, which is the pea protein, which I'm going to be using the pea protein in this soup also, okay? There we go. Yeah, now you can get this butternut squash, I know, at Publix. It already comes peeled and chopped up for you, but it's a lot cheaper to do to buy your own butternut squash and peel it yourself. It does take a little more time, but it's a little bit less expensive for you when you do it yourself, all right? But you can get it in chunks at the grocery store, all right, ready done up for you. All right, But this we're cooking it from the raw state. And if you like, if you have little kids, like babies, you can actually make baby food this way too. Okay, here we go. And then you'll know all the ingredients in there. All right, so we got all that. Let me get my mat. Here's this mat. I'm going to pick this up and throw out my peels here. All right. Got them. All right, now we're going to cut off the top here. All right, and we're going to cut off the bottom. There we go. And you see that scoop right there. We're going to cut that straight down. And I have a little bit there. Let's see if I can get that. Ooh. Get that out. I'm going to use our scoop loop. Actually, I'm going to cut this. Looks like this one's almost ready to go, too. All right, let's get that out. We don't want that part. I don't want that part either. Okay, we're just trying to cut up our butternut squash here. Okay, there's a good piece. All right, I need a garbage bowl. I need a garbage bowl, y'all. Got a garbage bowl. Stop looking, everybody. All right. Now, you can toast these seeds if you want. You can go right ahead and toast them. I'm not toasting them, y'all. Okay. Let's see if I can cut that off because that's not the best looking one there. Oops. There. And get that out. All right. So you want nice pieces of your butternut squash. And again, this one is a little bit on the... I thought it was a pretty new one, but I guess it's been sitting around a while. We don't want this part right here. Okay, we don't want the slimy part of the squash. All right. Usually the top is really pretty good. Ooh, I have that onion sitting there on me. All right, let me see. I have 9 new messages. All right, let me go back down. Hello, Sarah Sparkles. How are you doing? Is the skin thick as on the squash? Yes, it is. It is very thick and coarse. All right. Hey, buddy. How you doing? I'm doing good. Hope all is well with you, says Sarah to Knowledge. There you go. All right. So let's. All right. I read all your comments. Has anybody had butternut squash soup? Who's had butternut squash soup? Put a one in the box if you've had butternut squash soup. Okay. This can be a very small soup here. Let's see if I get the, use the scoop loop and get this thing out. Let's use the thicker side. There we go. Yeah. All right. Now, it would have been really easy for me to, like, just cut this up beforehand, but then you wouldn't be able to see it, okay? See me cutting it and how to cut a butternut squash, okay? So we're just going to scrape this out. This is a scoop loop. You can use it as a cookie cutter also, but it gets like the seeds out of like melons and cantaloupe, which is a melon, cucumbers, red bell peppers. Let's see what else. There we go. Just scrape it right out. It has like a serrated edge around it, and it's safe enough to use for kids. So it has a nice little serrated edge. You see it right there? It's a serrated edge, and we can... just get all those seeds out. Again, you can pick out the seeds and actually cook them or bake them, roasted butternut squash seeds, just like pumpkin seeds, all right? And you can grow your own butternut squash also from the seeds. But I am not a planter, y'all. I am like lucky I can keep a flower alive. There we go. All right, let's get it all out. We're trying to get that yuck out. All right, got it all out. Look at that. We did pretty good. I think we may have to use some of this one right here. Let's see if I can get some of this off. Because I don't have a lot. I thought I'd get a small butternut squash to do the soup because it makes quite a lot. Let's see if we can use that little part there. 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 Come on. There. All right, got it. All right, that's all done. All right, so now we're going to be putting it all together. We got everything prepped up, ready to go. All right, so let's review where we are right now, okay? Karen Sue says, make... Hey, Dooley, how you doing? You know, Dooley, that's great, but if you can follow along with us, that'd be great. And you can learn something here by cooking. All right. That would be really good. But for you to do stuff like that and to talk bad or give inappropriate comments, you can politely X yourself out. All right. Thank you, Dooley. All right. So anyway, we have the butternut squash soup. We're going to put in water, brown sugar, salt, cinnamon, and you can control the amount of brown su of sugar in there and also the salt. All right. Cinnamon, ground ginger, butternut squash, carrots, onions, cloves, and then instead of a dried apple, I'm putting a fresh apple in there. I'll also be adding some pea protein using less water and putting nutmeg into here. Okay. Which is about two. Let me see how much I have on here because I don't have a whole lot. And we're cooking it in the deluxe cooking blender, which is right here. The deluxe cooking blender. It's a Pampered Chef tool. It's a power tool by Pampered Chef. And the blender is $349 regularly, but in the month of April, Pampered Chef is having it on 20% off at $279 for this blender. Now, why would you want to spend this money on blender? Well, because you can make smoothies in the morning, soup in the afternoon, make your dinner marinara sauce in the afternoon, and then make some cold nice cream in the evening. All right. So you can keep this on the countertop. You can make your jams. You can make peanut butter. You can make so much stuff with this one blender and let it sit on your countertop. If you're putting your stuff away up and down, you're not going to use it. Okay. So that's that. We're going to put all of our stuff in. Let me measure some stuff out so I know how much I'm putting in there. Let's go by, let's get a 1 cup prep bowl out. There we go. And we're going to put our one little cup bowl down. And I need my knife back. And I'm going to cut my butternut up. There we go. And I'm going to see how much how much of this I have. All right. I think we might have 2 cups here. Okay, there's 1 cup. All right, 1 cup is there. And that looks about 2 cups. So we have about 2 cups. It calls for 2.5 cups. So we're a little bit shy, but no big deal. All right. And this is my blender. All right, here's the blender right here. And when the top is off, you can't use it, but we have it off of the thing. All right. All the mechanics are down the bottom. So you never wet this part right here. All right. I'm gonna put this straight down. I'm gonna open it up there. And we're gonna put it inside. All right, you're gonna see me put all the ingredients inside. So one, we're gonna start with about 2 cups. Oops, a little bit less than 2 cups. Let me see. I'm gonna do a little bit less. I'm gonna do about 1.5 cups of water. Cup and a half of water is gonna go in there, and then we're gonna add in 1 tablespoon of brown sugar. Okay, and we've got our nice little adjustable measuring spoon. So 1 tablespoon. A tablespoon, when you do it, is flat. Okay, so you're not going to do an overflowing thing of brown sugar. We're going to do 1 tablespoon of brown sugar goes in there. That's done. We're going to do some salt. 1 teaspoon of salt. Where's my salt sugar? There you go. And again, if you're on high blood pressure and they say, hey, limit that salt, then cut back on the salt. Okay. So we're going to, and you know me, I'm not a big salt thing. So I'm probably going to even use less salt. I can always add salt, but it's really hard to put away. So I'm going to use about 1/2 teaspoon of salt in here. So I'm cutting my salt back also. So I cut back my brown sugar and I'm cutting back my salt. All right. There we go. Never knew until now how much I needed a Pampered Chef blender, says Ann Rush. Yeah, okay. It's true because you can make everything in it. All right, so we have our brown sugar, salt. We're going to do 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon. Now, you know me with cinnamon. I love cinnamon, right? There we go. I'll probably do a little more than that. There we go. 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon. And we're going to do some ground ginger, okay? And if you want fresh ginger, you can do the fresh ginger in here. We had Darby just come live, and she showed us how to make ginger. This is going to be 1/4 teaspoon of ginger, okay? There we go. There. All right. Next seasoning we're going to do is our I've got to open up my cabinet here, y'all. Hold on. Oops. There, Borden House reach here, stretching across, y'all. Okay, we're gonna do some nutmeg. All right, and the nutmeg just gives it a nice flavor to it. Okay, and I'm gonna use my zester. Now we're in Darby's thing, and Jay Opera said he needed a microplane zester. This is the Pampered Chef one, and we can put that right in. I'm just using a little bit, trying to use up all of my nutmeg in here. Okay. I'm using just a little bit. Like, I got like a tiny bit on my zester here. There you go. The blender will chew it up, but I'm trying to use it all up. There we go. We got it all done. Okay. Got all that done. The other zester that I have that looks like Darby's is this one here. And this does the same job, except it's a lot bigger. And you can do like your oranges, lemons, grapefruits, anything that's really big. And it also comes with a juicer right here, which is 18 ounces, which is like a cup and a half. Okay. So we got that. Let me put this back there. Oops. All right. So now we have all of our seasonings in here. We have our water, brown sugar, salt, cinnamon, ground ginger, and a little bit of nutmeg, which is what we added. All right. We're going to add in our veggies, which is about 2 cups of butternut squash. Let me see if I can break that. There we go. There we go. Put that in there. It doesn't matter what it looks like. Just put it all in. We have one medium carrot. It was like 2 small carrots we had in there. Here's another butternut. We have an apple. Put the apple with the peel in it. We're just putting it all raw, okay? And we're going to put in our onion. There we go. And I think I have a lot of onion. Yeah, I think I'm going to leave some onion out, okay? There we go. Got all that. So we added everything else in here. We added our 3 cups of butternut squash. We only had about 2, maybe 2.5. So we did a little short. Carrots, onion, garlic clove. Yeah, I put the garlic clove. Here's a garlic clove right there in there. And one small apple we put in here. And that's it. All right. We're going to put our lid on here. Oh, wait a minute. Let's put in some pea protein. Okay. I'm going to just throw in. You can put the pea protein in now or you can put it in at the end. I think I'll put it in now. We'll see how it works. Let's put in at least one. I can always add more in at the end. 2. This is going to make 6 servings. Okay, I'm going to do 3. We'll do 3. Okay, there. And if we don't have enough veggies in it, you can always add some Enrichables super veggies in there also. Okay, this just gives you a little boost. I'm only going to do one veggie in there because we have a lot of veggies already in there. There we go. All right. All done. Now, there we go. So there's our container, and I'm going to flip us around. There we go. And I have my cabinet open. And we have our ingredients right in here. So we're going to put the blender right there. It's not on. It has an on and off switch right there. It says lid because we need the lid. We're going to put the lid right on. There. We're going to go all the way over to soup and push the button. And now we're going to have soup. And we don't even have to touch any of it. Pretty cool, right? All right. So we got the soup going right there. We got our leftover peels in here that we're going to put this away in the freezer. All right. There we go with that. Let me see if I can clean up over here. Got my knife, book. Got some other little stuff we could wash up. We have that can go in there. Let's see what else. This can go down there. I'm trying to clean up so I can pull you over on the other side. Right. Yeah, so the blender is a phenomenal tool by Pampered Chef, y'all. You can make your own peanuts in there because a lot of peanut butter like Jif, Skippy, I don't know, sure what brand y'all use, but if I look on the back of it, sometimes they add sugar and sometimes they add salt into it. But you can get yourself a can of peanuts or roasted peanuts and put it in there and have grind it and have your own fresh peanut butter. I'm going to have to get a blender, says Sarah Sparkles. Yes, and Sarah, talking about that. All right.
It doesn't cost you anything to host your own party, all right, to get it. But you do get a lot of benefits when you host your party. The higher the sales, I send you a couple catalogs. You can pass them out to your friends, or you can send them to your friend or invite them to a party, all right? And I do all the work. I give you one post to do a day and talk to your friends. That's pretty much it. So the blender is normally $349. If you want to buy it outright right now today on the Mystery Show, it's $279. With free shipping, because Pepper Chef has free shipping when you spend $150 or more. Can it be made? Yeah, it can make chocolate pudding. It can. There's another thing that makes. There's another one that have a recipe that you can make whipped cream in here. Banner Daughter, you can make whipped cream. Just get heavy whipping cream, put your flavored sweetener and flavor it in there, and whip it up. It only takes seconds to make a lot of whipped cream in there. Okay. Let's see. So you can pay right now if you want to buy it today. It's $279. $279. Just put it on the Mystery Show. You're going to get about eight tickets into the party itself. Okay. All right. So if you are a past host, all right, such as like my friend Gaylene or Kristen or who else is past host? Karen. Let me see, Sue. All right, so I'm trying to think of all the hosts. They can get it for $251 right now with 10% off of that. They get the 20% plus another 10%, so $251. But the cheapest way to get this blender for $111, it has to be done in the month of April, okay? It's to host your own show. You get $200 worth of orders. You can get this blender for $111. $111, y'all. And it comes with its own cookbook. And it comes with me, too, okay? Because you see me using this, all right? Alexis just said she's your friend with benefits. Katharina, yeah, I'm your friend with benefits, exactly. Yeah, and I'm everybody's friend. I think I'm everybody's friend. I don't think I have too many any bad ones, except for a couple of food trolls that don't know how to cook, and they're talking nonsense. So anyway, the cooking blender, it comes with its own cookbook, and every 6 months, Pampered Chef comes out with another little cookbook that usually has an additional thing in here, but it tells you how to make smoothies, which I'm not a smoothie eater anymore. I started broadcasting, doing food quotes, and then I moved up to my little red ninja. Y'all remember my little red ninja? And I used to do smoothies. I used to make all different types of smoothies. And then I started gaining weight, and now I'm trying to lose weight. So no smoothies. I have to eat all my stuff, right? It has sweet potato soup. However, I did eat the sweet potato soup. I'd rather have a sweet potato than the sweet potato soup. I'm just used to it that way. But if you have a baby, make your own sweet potatoes for the baby, okay? Gerber, move aside, because we got the deluxe cooking blender here for babies, all right? And it tells you all different types of smoothies on this one right here. Let's see. I could flip the camera around. We can look at it other way rather than, because this is heating up to 212 degrees. You can see it's like, it's really thick. So it's super thick right now. It's at 129 degrees, okay? Going up to 131 degrees. And one, you don't have to use an immersion blender, okay? Or cook it on the stove and keep stirring it. It does it all itself, okay? So let's flip us over around here this way. Back over here. Back over. Put that knife out of the way. And I'll show you the cookbook. All right. So it comes with, you can do smoothie bowls. We've done a smoothie bowl before here on camera. Okay. It gives you the recipes for a green mango coconut smoothie bowl or a blackberry cashew smoothie bowl. It does alternative milks. So if you want to do almond milk, which we need to do almond milk, I got almonds I got to use up. Cashew milk, coconut milk, combination milks, macadamia milk. Who knows? Who knew all these milks existed, right? Oat milk. We can do oat milk. I gotta get oatmeal. Rice milk. Okay, so you can do all the milks. And with like the almond milk, with the mush that's left over, you can bake it in your oven and make almond flour. All right. So horchata. Somebody said this is really good, but I'm not a milk drinker. And I'm sure it tastes great, good, because this one has long grain rice, 5 cups of water, 1 stick of cinnamon, vanilla extract, and a half a cup of sweetened condensed milk. Okay. So yum, 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 yum. Is that good? Yeah.
Have you tried it? And here it has the different butters, almond butter, cashew, peanut butter, sunflower seed oil, which is not a butter. It's a seed butter. And then we have super seed butters, okay, which you put combinations of stuff in there. The other one is you can also do grind your own flours, okay? You can grind your own oat flour from oatmeal, all right? Pancakes. This one here, we've done the hummus so many times here. And this red pepper one is great. It has a walnuts in it. Yum. All right. Let's see. Soups. Beet soup, cauliflower, mushroom, potato, sweet potato, and tomato basil. There's also a broccoli soup, but the broccoli soup does smell, okay? You know how broccoli smells. The tomato basil, phenomenal. Phenomenal, phenomenal. And we're, of course, we're doing the butternut squash soup on this one. Here's the broccoli cheddar. This one tastes great, but my coworkers, when I brought it to work and reheated it, it's like, don't make that again. It stinks. All right. And then this is one of my favorite ones. You have purees. You have beet puree, broccoli, carrot, cauliflower, parsnip, and sweet potato puree. However, this hidden veggie marinara sauce, once you make this marinara sauce, you'll never go back to canned sauce, okay, unless it's like emergency. But all it is for the sauce is water, Italian seasoning, salt, 4 garlic cloves, a carrot, and then a zucchini, and then you add in a can of diced tomatoes. So, so good, y'all. Okay. I made a tiny in my blender. It was a mess. I made it. Oh, what did you make in your blender? It was a mess. A homemade ketchup. Oh, yes. We need to make homemade ketchup. Just make it on your, you can make it on your stovetop. On your stovetop. Unless you're making with real tomatoes, I guess. You can do gravies in here. Chicken or beef gravy, sausage, or Alfredo grado. I've never made Alfredo sauce in here. Only because it's high in calories, y'all. And I don't want to make it. Okay. But I've seen so many other consultants make the Alfredo sauce. You can make ice cream. Okay. We did the, oh, look at ice cream base. Okay. The Hollandaise sauce and hot chocolate. You saw me make the ice nice cream in here. Here's the nacho sauce using the Alfredo sauce. Okay. The cheese sauce. Jams. You see me making jams in there. I love lemon marmalade. Rather than orange marmalade, take it up a notch. Yum, yum, yum. We did strawberry in here before. All right. Then you have a chocolate skillet cake you can make. All right. And other stuff, milkshakes, the nice creams, which I was talking about, and then frozen adult beverages, or you can do them non-alcoholic also. Okay. But it's the blender. It is right now, today, it is at 20% off. It's $279, well worth your investment. Or if you want to do it less expensive, you can host your own party and get it for $112. Okay. So great tool to have in your kitchen, and it looks really pretty on your countertops. All right. Let me flip over and see y'all, and I can read the comments better this way. All right. So hello, everybody. Hey, it's Alexis, your Pampered Chef Consultant, and I'm coming live here on HAPS. I'm trying to come live at about 12:15, 12:30. We had Darby go on, so I waited until Darby was finished before I started my broadcast today, and we're making some butternut squash soup. It takes about 30 minutes in the blender. It needs to heat up to 212 degrees because it needs to cook the raw vegetables that are in there, okay? And boy, I got to get rid of this onion, y'all. It's a potent. Hey, Mike. Oh my gosh, Mike's in the house. We got to put I'm smelling up my house here. I think I need a bigger bowl, Alexis. No, Alexis is going to fit this thing in. I think I'll put a lid on it. Let's see if it fits in. Of course not. Oh, it fit. It fit. It's not going to stink up my refrigerator. All right. Not that. All right. Got that, y'all. We're all done with that. We can put our brown sugar away because I know I have enough sweetness in there. You're welcome, Mike. Well, I have to do something different. I have to, when you broadcast, you need to know your audience. And my audience for Pampered Chef is in the United States. All right. And I've always scoped at like 6:30 in the morning, 6, 7 o'clock, between 6 and 7 in the morning. And, I get a lot of Europeans, no problem with Europeans. Okay. But, for me to sell in my business, I need to be where the people are at the right time. So the timing might be wrong where I was before. So that's why I'm changing it up. Plus, then I get to sleep in late, y'all. I slept in to like, I don't know, I had the alarm go off still at 5 o'clock in the morning. And I'm thinking, that alarm needs to go off at 6. I'm going to change my alarms to 6, okay? And then I can stay up later because I find that, like, I have people
messaging me 8 o'clock at night or 9 o'clock at night, and I'm ready to go to sleep if you wake up at 5 and 9 o'clock, you know? So that's that. Hey, daughter, how you doing? Thanks for practice. Yeah. Hi, they're missed in your quiz. Yeah. How did you do in your quiz there? Because you soaked the rice in the blender. Yes. For the hortensia, are you talking about that? We can make it, but then I don't want to drink it. I'm really bad. Like, I know. All right. So what's one food, y'all? All right. We have a few people in here. What's one food you don't like to eat? One food, or maybe two, put two or three foods that you're like, eh, I'll pass on that. Okay. One is milk. I'm lucky I put it into a recipe, the milk. All right. I don't know why. I mean, it's okay. But no, y'all, milk, I don't care what kind of milk, almond milk, whatever it is. I'm like, I can take the almond milk in recipes more than I can the other milk, but I will put it in there, y'all. Milk is one. Another one is avocados. I don't mind if somebody else makes it, but for me, I get frustrated with avocados. Avocados frustrate me more than any other fruit or vegetable in the world. Avocados, because I buy them, they're hard as rocks. When I open them up, they're black. Not good. I still have some frozen avocados in the freezer, though. It leaked. Oh my gosh. Whatever leaked is not good. Okay, so Sarah says kale. Oh, I got kale in the refrigerator. I do kale. Okay, so kale is one of those things you either like or you don't. And Pampered Chef has a kale fiber for you. Let me get it out right over here. And you see, I don't promote it, but it's kale fiber, and it's green, and it tastes like kale, y'all. I don't care what you're putting this in. It doesn't mask it. So I'm not selling this out the window. If anybody wants a packet, message me. I will send you 2 packets, okay? I'll send you 2 packets of the kale. You can taste it. You can put it in your food just like I put in the pea protein over there. I can eat the pea protein like this. It's good. The this one here is going to be really good in banana bread or stuff that's more fallish because it has a pumpkin taste in it. Okay. So let's see. Brussels sprouts. Oh, Brussels sprouts are really good. That's like mini cabbage. You don't like cabbage then, Anne. Anne, do you like cabbage? Because Brussels sprouts are like mini cabbage. Only they're cute. They're really cute. And they grow like a tree on a stalk. They're really, if we ever saw a Brussels sprout tree, it's really fun. You don't like mayonnaise. Okay, yeah. Mayonnaise is not my cup of tea, but I do need to have mayonnaise into some salads, y'all. Yeah, that tuna fish. That Greek yogurt just doesn't do it for me. Mayonnaise. I'll take the calories on the mayonnaise. Let's see. Me too, says Sarah. I don't like to drink milk, says Facebook user. Yeah, I'm not. My mother used to put us we used to get a glass of milk at every meal. Cow's milk, y'all. I would have to drink that. But to this day, that's just like vomitose, y'all. And then my aunt Teresa, bless her heart. She's up in heaven looking down at me saying I should have never done that. But we had Cheerios one day before we went to church. Y'all heard this story, right? We should put Cheerios and she put milk in it. And I don't like cereal and I don't like milk. And not only did it sit there, she made me eat it after church, like 2 hours later. I had to eat that stuff. I was like, oh my God, that was nasty. So to this day, if I put milk in cereal, you can weigh the milk in and weigh the milk out, and it's almost the same. 7 new messages. Okay, avocados from Mexico, says Cap in Rehab. There we go. I'll try it. Spinach is a vegetable that doesn't change the taste. Spinach is a vegetable that doesn't change the taste. I don't know. I like fresh spinach versus cooked spinach. If you ever notice when I do my spinach and my omelets, I keep it like whole, or I'll just wilt it a little bit. I don't like that one that's frozen. It's mushed up. Don't know why. I use olive oil, tuna fish. I've never done olive oil. Hey, Facebook user, who are you? What's your name? Because it just says Facebook user. It doesn't give us your name from Facebook. You like olive oil. So I never tried olive oil in tuna fish salad. That would be good. Do you make homemade bread? Yes. Yes. And you know what? I actually wanted to make homemade bread today because we don't have any bread in the house. Well,
mom has a thing over there. But the homemade bread smells great, and it's really, yeah, we've made a lot of homemade bread, and we've made it in the enamel cast iron Dutch oven. And boy, does that come out really, really good. It's crusty. It's so good. We put the Parmesan on top. I don't even change the recipe. That's how good it is. Okay. But it does need to rise up, and we use the quick cooker to proof our bread, and it takes a lot. It's a lot quicker. So Terry says, I used the kale you sent me in my meatloaf, weeded it up, and no one said anything. Okay. Oh, I sent you one of those. Kale. Who wants a kale? I'll send you kale. Okay. Send you the kale. Just send me a message. Okay. Message me. Y'all know how to find me. All right. Hey, Demi, how are you doing? How are you doing, Demi? Facebook user can't reply to you. Yeah, he can. He's listening to me, or she's listening to me. She can reply. When you add it to smoothies, when you add it to smoothies, what am I adding to? Oh, you mean the spinach? I don't know. That's another thing. I don't like green drinks. I don't like cold green drinks. I can eat spinach soup, it's green. I could eat split pea soup, it's hot, it's green. But when you put a smoothie and it's green, that's worse than milk. That's right up there. See, even I have problems with some food, but you know, I do try it. Frozen spinach, I tried once and never again, says Anne. Frozen spinach is only good, I think, if you put it into like a spinach and artichoke dip. I think that would be good, okay? Or maybe spanakopita, okay? I don't care for milk or cereal. Michael loves fresh spinach. He doesn't care much for cooked spinach. Black licorice. Oh, man, Banner daughter. Hey, Banner, are you Bannerman's daughter? No, Bannerman doesn't have a daughter, does he? When I saw your name, I saw you earlier today in Bannerman's scope, and I'm like, does he have a daughter? Because I know he's signing everybody up to HAPS here. Let's see, Dooley. We're just going to skip you, okay? Doing thanks, guys. Thank you for the high five award, Demi. How are you doing? Hey, Space Force Captain, how are you doing? What Space Force are you at? Are you here on the East Coast? Let's see. I think so. Hey, Mike, thank you for the high five over there. All right, we're right up to speed right now. I'm up to speed. Let me see what the temperature is over here. It's 210 degrees, and boy, it's smelling very oniony over there. I'm glad I cut back on that onion. All right, so let's see. Well, that needs to be washed. All right, I'm just trying to put some stuff away here, too. All right, let me put you over here, and I can put my cinnamon back, which goes on the other side. We can put that back. That goes way over there. Hold on a second, y'all. I'm going to put some of my stuff back there and drink some water. There we go. Ooh, there. Are you Bannerman's daughter for real? Now, Bannerman is supposed to be having a Pampered Chef show, all right? So get with him, Bannerman. Okay, get with Bannerman. And let's have a blowout show. And so does Sarah needs to host a show, because she needs the, Sarah, you need the garlic peeler, or the garlic press. Sarah, I know Bannerman's daughter has this. This thing here is called the mix and chop. Yesterday, you had your nice little, you had a spatula. I think you had a wooden spatula. There it goes to my mom's phone again. And you're cutting up the meat this way. Look at this. When you cut the meat this way, it grinds it up five times as fast. Wow, what's that?
Call from AGGSDNGN1.
His ex-wife's daughter. Oh, his ex-wife's daughter. Okay. So this is what Sarah needs. It's a mix and chop. Okay. It's only like $15. All right. Definitely need this one in your repertoire. Okay. You can also vent pies with this. You can imprint cookies and make them look like starfish. Okay. And it chops up or grinds up ground beef, turkey, chicken, you name it, like nobody's business. Oh, my mad. Sorry. Hi, my Uncle Rich daughter. There you go. All right. And then Sarah, I'm frozen in time here. All right. So anyway, this one here is the other thing that everybody needs this if you don't have this in your house. Okay. This is a garlic press. All right. And the garlic press, you put your whole garlic with the peel on it and all, and you squish it out, and swipe it off. And then this thing here is a little Barbie brush. You put it inside and it cleans it, y'all. It goes right in and it goes into those holes and it cleans it. Okay. So it cleans in between the holes. But this is two things that we have on Sarah's wish list. Two things, Sarah. Sometimes the small things make a big difference, okay? And actually, the garlic press was one of my very first purchases by Pampered Chef, the garlic press. Not this one exactly. There's another one floating around my house. I forgot where I put it. That is my original garlic press. I only use this one because this one has a better brush on it. The other one attaches up here and stuff. All right. That's a good, yeah, this is a really good one. Yes, I don't, you don't have these two things, small things, but you're like, then if you ever need to clunk somebody on the head, you can go, yeah. Talking about clunking people on the head, Bryce called me last night. Bryce got an Every Plate box yesterday. His box came yesterday. And so he's going to be cooking some Every Plate at his residence. He's my, this order is for my parents. Great. Okay. This order's for your parents. All right. Is that Sarah? I don't know. I know Sarah's ordering for her parents large bar pan, tennis shoes, and a dress. Yes, tennis shoes and a dress. Yep, got my dress on, got my shoes on, you know. I'm not impressing anybody. I even got paparazzi on, Sarah. Sarah, do you have this? Do you have this to sell? We can sell this right now. Sarah sells paparazzi. So does Monica. And it comes with these nice earrings, and it's $5. $5 for the earrings and the necklace, y'all. And then you can get a bracelet. Yeah, both these are paparazzis too. This is $5 and this is $5. Okay. And I look like $1 million with my tennis shoes on and my nice little dress. I blinged it up today. Yeah. And I got my nice little dress on. Look, my nice little thing. And I got my Spanx on underneath here. So if my skirt flies up, no one's seen anything. Of course, we are. I always look fabulous. Thank you. Never again. I don't want any. Julie? I'm having too much fun without one. So anyway, Julie, you should join the party, okay? Just come in and join us. You're going to learn something, right? You are learning something, right? So anyway, what are your top 10 favorite products? Well, we can divide that up into small gadgets and big gadgets, okay? Mm-hmm. Small gadgets, definitely. Well, you see me, the mats that you see me use all the time, these babies here, small ones and the large ones, mats. Definitely the garlic press. You see me use this several times a week, all right? We can divide it up into old tools and new tools too. The knives, no matter if you have the coated knives or the stainless steel knives, the big knives. Here, we get the big knife. We get Bryce's big knife out. The big knife. Bryce even has a knife like this. This is the chef's knife. Make sure that you pinch it. Okay. That's what that little circle is there for right-handed people. Put your thumb right there and put the other one. It's actually P on each side. The P is where the thumb goes. Okay. And then this one here is rock and roll. Okay. Whereas the Santuco is chop up and down. Okay. So knives are a must in every kitchen. Small stuff. Oh, those, I got the bananas over here. We're going to make that banana thing again. This little trivet, the trivets, you all need a trivet in your house. Just keep this on your countertop so that when you have something hot, you can land it on it. And this is a set of trivets, so you can like do different ones. All right. So you can move it around. If you have a couple different pots, just move it. Okay. Let's see. The peelers. I love. All right, so this one here is a set of, there are three peelers, all right? And everybody needs a peeler in their kitchen. This is the regular peeler, this array of peeler, and I absolutely love this one. This one here is worth $15 just by itself, and it's a Julianne peeler. Absolutely love this. Another tool that I use, small tool, basting brush. You're always going to have the baste, like barbecue sauce on something, butter on something, mayonnaise on something. Actually, I need another one of these because sometimes I like to do it and I'm like, oh man, I already dirtied that one up. So yeah, this one here is absolutely a must in everybody's kitchen. Scrapers, small ones. All right, so there's different sizes of scrapers and let's see. And there's different types of scrapers. This is like... I have two of these. I have two of the same ones, y'all. Okay. But this is a big one. All right. And then there's even a smaller one. I should go back and get my box. My box that came the last party that we had with the shared rewards. I actually ordered stuff. I need a pair of scissors, but where did I put my scissors at? Oh, here's a pair of scissors right here. These scissors are great because no one in your kitchen is going to steal them because they have no idea how to open them or use them. So it's one scissors to definitely keep in your tool turnaround. All right. So these are the small stuff I'm talking about right now. My favorite small tools I can't show. And you notice I kept them out on my countertops. Because if you put them away, they're hidden. This one is the same. Alright. Is it the same one? No. Alright. So. Alright. Three different sizes of the scraper. All right, you got the big baby here, which I got the big one. Is that the big one? No, that's a medium one. That's a medium one. All right, so let's get this one out because I don't have this one. I don't have this one. I was trying to figure out which ones I don't have. Oh, Julie, but you know what? You don't cook. Julie, you got to stop because you don't know what you're talking about. You don't know what you're talking about. All right, so three different scrapers here. This is my brand new one. Look how big this baby is. All right, this is for a man's hand. Julie, this one's for you. All right, so there you go. And then you have my little one that I love the best. I like the smallest one the best. And you can see the difference in the sizes of these scrapers, okay? So if you're having a big, like a big guy, a guy would come over and get this one. This is huge, y'all. This is big. All right, so those three. And then we have these side scraper ones. Let me see which one I have. I have this one. And I have this one. All right, now I gotta get the other one out that I don't have. The big one. All right, I didn't have the big one. Wow, we got a few extras here. I got a lot of extra scrapers, which I can give them away as gifts. All right. All right. We need to give a scraper away. All right. What shall I do? He got the cheap stuff. Yeah. Julie has the cheap stuff, so he keeps on buying it over and over again. I'm sorry, Julie. You know, we're just picking on you, Julie, because you don't cook. You buy your stuff. You know, you go out and you eat out all the time. You're spending all your money and you're wasting it. All right, so here's three different scrapers, okay? All right, you got the big baby. Oh, that's the big baby. Three scrapers, all right? And I love this little tiny one. You see me use this all the time on the whipped cream maker, the tiny one. It's for my little hand. They had the bigger one, which I didn't have the big one. And they all come with a Pampered Chef. You can see that the handles got a little worn, okay, between the two of them. But the white part is still, this one actually looks whiter than the other one. But they're still the same whiteness, all right? Even though these are as old as the brand new one. They're still as white as day. Now, you can tell how old your scraper is. Hey, Darby, how are you doing? From Loveland, Texas. I mean, Twitter. Right. All right. So anyway, you can tell how old your Pampered Chef scraper is by the back sundial back here, and it'll tell you the year. This one was manufactured in 2016, and it was manufactured in February of 2016. So this one here is what? Wow, how old is this thing's old, y'all? This is 5 years old. This one here is 5 years old. Now the one I just opened. This one says, oh my gosh, I need a. It says month four, okay, but it has it so small, I need a magnifying glass. Nope, it says 2020. All right, so this says, I actually could see it right here. That's, oh my God, I'm doing good with my eyes here. So this one here is made in October of 2020. So this one here is October of 2020, and this one here is in, February of 2016. And you can see that they're pretty much, it's still brand new looking. All right. Now these other ones here, now these I use all the time. You can see I use them a lot. All right. This one here is 2015. All right. And it's still white. All right. So that's those. All right. Got all those. And I don't need these anymore. That there, and my soup's done. See that? Now we could have been doing anything. Once we get that all that stuff prepped up, it's saying Alexis, open me up, right? They look brand new. Exactly, they do look brand new. Even though they've been what, 5 years old. Actually, this one must have come in the kit. One of these came in my original Pamper Chef kit, 2015, and this one is 2017. So this one came in my kit. And you could tell, like, I had ink on it. I had put ink in my tool turnaround and it bled, but the ink's not coming off. And I burnt it. Oops. But anyway, it's still, the head part is what counts. That goes into the food, and it's still looking so good, all right? So anyway, those are my nice little ones. They're nice. All right. And I can probably get these white again, like super, super white, if I put in some Socom and then put in Bon Annie or Barkeeper's Friend, and it'll come clean on that too. I've done worse. You burned some stuff, okay? All right, so my soup is done, y'all. All right. I'm glad y'all kept with me here. So we're making butternut squash soup, and we went over the entire book for the deluxe cooking blender. And you notice... I do keep my blender and my quick cooker on my countertops. I have a very small kitchen, but I found room for these because if I put them away, it's going to stay away. It's going to be hidden away. And you're like, I'm not going to drag that out. So, and it's going to beep. It's going to still keep beeping at me until I press cancel, which we can, or open up the lid. And it says lid down on here. Yeah, this is butternut squash soup. It was made with fresh butternut squash. If you want the recipe, please reach out to me or I'll post it in my VIP group, okay? So we put in here water, brown sugar. We cut the brown sugar in half, all right? Salt, I cut the salt in half because I can always add a little more salt if I want to, all right? We did cinnamon, ground ginger, and I added in some nutmeg in here. Thank you, Darby Jones, for the Super Heart Award. We did put in butternut squash. I showed you how to peel it, cut it. We put it all in there. We put in some carrots, an onion, garlic cloves, and an apple. It calls for a dried apple, but I substitute a fresh apple, including the rind, okay? You know, Julie, I didn't turn around for you to do that. Julie, can you stand up and turn around for us? We want to watch you. Okay. Stand up and turn around for us. All right. So anyway, this soup is 0 points on my Weight Watchers journey. Well, actually, it has a point for the brown sugar in there. It has brown. It has 1 point for the brown sugar for, actually it's 4 points for one whole tablespoon. Okay. So no big deal. It's only a little bit of amount. All right. And Julie, there you go. Somebody, oh. That one got disappeared. That comment disappeared. How did that happen? Hey, Monica, how you doing? Monica, we have some paparazzi on today. I'm a paparazzi styling, y'all. Okay. You muted him. Okay, thanks. I didn't know y'all can do that. Oh, because I put you in as my moderator. There he goes again. I didn't know you can do it on Facebook that you can mute the people. Go back and mute them all, Darby. If you don't mind, just mute them. Actually, if we can just make him disappear, poof, that would be wonderful. But he needs help. Dooley needs help. He needs some help in the kitchen because he doesn't cook. He doesn't have the tools, and he needs some tools. Anna, do you have this? We can sell it right here on screen. I'm on it. There you go. So this is our butternut squash soup. It's a little browner looking than normal because I put that potato or the thing on it. Okay. Let's get our tasting spoons out and our... This is part of the charcuterie line with Pampered Chef. And I always use like a little sample. We're going to get a little sample out. I mean, I'm going to get a small, let's get this out. Okay. Oops. We got to take the lid off first. There we go. Oh, look how hot that is. So let's just take a little bit out. All right. And we're going to sample it. Okay. And I need my spoon. and we sample it. And this is where you say you're going to, when you sample food, you're going to, when you put it on your palate, you're going to think of everything that you put in there. Can you taste the nutmeg? Can you taste the brown sugar? Can you taste the sugar? Do you taste the onion, the carrot? Okay. Hey there, John. How are you doing? I love that pepper shake. Thanks, Monica. So anyway, I think about what I'm wearing every day before I get, like, I already chose this outfit last night and I was like, I'm wearing this one today. All right. And then this morning I got up and was like, this needs a splash of bling. All right. So anyway, and I love your hat, Darby. Your hat was fab. Okay. However, I don't have my countertops are too low. And if I put you over on top of the stove, then it gets overexposed. So that double broadcast thing that you do, I love that. I love your setup. All right. Mm-mm-mm. Oh, different today. All right. Could use a little more sweetness, but I'm okay with it. I ate it all up, y'all. It must be great. Hey, Sarah Ziegler, you're on Facebook now. All right, Sarah. There you go. That's Sarah. That's Sarah Sparkles. Okay. Let's see. Yummy, in my tummy. I could probably put a little more sugar in here, but that's about it. That's the only thing I'll change on there. We do need a container so I can put this in. And I'm going to have this for my lunch. All right. You can top it. It does come with in the recipe, it calls for like a granola topping on it. But I skipped that. It comes with a pumpkin seed granola. All right. And I skipped that part altogether. However, you can make your own croutons and put croutons on here. They are so good with croutons. I've done that one before. All right. What else can you serve with this soup? I need a cup of soup, y'all. We need a little bowl of soup. I'm going to eat some on you. Let's do a small bowl. I don't need a big bowl. Do a small bowl. All right. I love this color. This one here is by 31. It was on the outlet a year ago or so, maybe 2 years ago. Probably 2 years ago. There we go. Let's cool this thing off. Get my spoon, and we are ready to go. A little hot still, but deliciousness. All right. Delicious. It's very, 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 very hot. All right. All right. I'm going to put us back over here because I'm going to get a container to put this in. And my container is underneath you. My container's underneath us. So y'all, all right, hold on. Let's just get the container out without. All right. There we go. Phew. All right. There we go. All right. Got it. All right. So I have my 5-cup leak-proof container by Pampered Chef, and we're going to put our soup in here so it can cool down. All right. So let's put it right in. All right. I already took out maybe a cup on here. All right. Let's get that spoon back over here and just get it all out. There we go. Get it out. All right. All right, pretty much good. All right, so I have this left. We're going to rinse it out. Just rinse. I'm going to clean this right in front of you, all right? Because you're going to see I don't spend hardly any time cleaning up. Let me do it one more time. Rinse it at the bottom. Actually, I got some stuff on the bottom. Let's get a little bit of soap. Just a tad bit of soap on here. And there's a little bit of stuff on the bottom. I'm going to use my brush on that first. Normally don't have anything on the bottom, but I guess the sugar got down there. All right. Let's rinse that out. Do not submerge your blender in the water because all of your components are right down here. Okay. So we're going to add in 3 cups of water. Yeah. If you add in hot water, it comes to pressure or it comes to heat a lot quicker. All right. So 3 cups. There we go. Turn it over here. Somebody was trying to call me, y'all. All right. So anyway, here we go. Put that in.
one dip of that, and I rinse out my lid. All right. Because don't we all rinse? Do y'all rinse? Why don't have to make it a full screen? So weird. Full screen? I don't know. I am full screen. I'm on portrait. Where are you at, Demi? You are here. You're on half, so it should be full screen. Hi, and halfway through your quiz, haven't forgotten. Thanks for the canal walk. There you go. All right. I'm putting that down. Now, there is a gasket that you can take off. I don't take it off every single time, but there's a gasket on here. It's right here. This part right here that comes off. You can clean underneath that also. All right. Just make sure it's on really good when you're washing. All right. We're going to push this to heat it wash. It goes up to 140 degrees, so it's going to clean it really good. All right. Got my soup ready to go. And look at that. It's cleaning right in front of us, y'all. Is it full screen and portrait on my phone? Yeah, it's full screen portrait on your phone. So, Demi, what is it looking like for you? Are you on the computer? If it's on the computer, it's going to look different. Then you have to do it landscape, and I don't do landscape because when I do landscape, we get you get all my other stuff here, and it's just hard for me. That's it. Let's see. I want to buy a microplane zester, says Darby from Alexis. Okay. You'll DM me later. All right. We're going to put it on the mystery show so you can get that one. Okay. And it just came back in stock. It was off. No, on my phone. It should be on. It should be full screen. Like, it's full screen. And when I broadcast all the stuff I want you to see on the top here because I know all the comments are on the bottom. Okay. And I know if there's no comments, they do disappear and then you see the full screen. Okay. Hey, Sarah. Yeah. All right. Oh, man. Got our nice look. And again, croutons would be great on this. It is still wicked hot, y'all. Still wicked hot. It's keeping it really, really hot. All right. So I noticed that too on landscape. But if I rotate phone into portrait, it only shows a small square. Yes, I do believe so. I don't know. I've just been broadcasting portrait for the longest time, and I know it looks good on Facebook, which is where I like to have people go over to. And it does look good on when I do landscape. The field is too big. Landscape is great if you're sitting in front of the computer and broadcasting. No doubts about it. When you're outside, landscape is perfect. Landscape. Okay. But when you're cooking and you want to focus in on like one thing like this, you want it. And you see how I have it like right on the top of the screen. That's pretty much, I do it on half the screen. So even when I flip my camera over, I make sure that what you're seeing, and I'll show you on the other side when I flip it on this side here. You're going to see my other side. So see, that's where I normally scope from right here. I'm going to move this. And here's our mix and chop for Sarah. All right. There. And I put you over here. So when you're here, I try to line up my mat. All right. So it's on the top half of the screen and the bottom half is for comments. All right. Cause you don't really need to see me. All right. And then we put this right in the middle. And so when the computer's in the kitchen, I look over at the computer and I make sure that this is centered. And sometimes like when I'm broadcasting with Aiden and we're both doing landscape, I sort of move it to where the center is. Okay. And we have a minute and 42 seconds. No, we have 2 minutes. 2 minutes for our machine to clean. Okay. So that's how I figure it out from there. Or like we get the cold brew coffee pitcher and I'll put it right in front so that you see it. It's right in this top half of the screen. All right. Does that make sense to everybody? All right. Let's see. Aiden, I just see Alexis in the middle. So small. I'm using Galaxy. Oh, you know, I have a big phone. I have the iPhone 12 Max Pro, whatever. It's like a big phone. It's like, let me see. I got that.
I measure stuff on here. It is inches. My phone is about 6 1/4 inches. 6 1/4 by 3 inches. 6 1/4 by 3 inches. And if you're on cms, okay, centimeters, the phone is 16 by 8. 16 by 8 cms, right? Yeah, it's a big phone. It's a big phone. Because when you broadcast, I want to see it. And that's how I can see the comments. The comments, I put large comments on my phone under the settings. And I always put large comments. So I can see the, I can't see the comments without my glasses, though, okay? But I can stand here and read your comments, no problem. I can even stand here and still read your comments, all right? Reading the comments on the computer is a little bit more difficult. They're smaller on the computer for me. I'll try that. I'm starting to prefer portraits, says Aiden. It all depends, Aiden, because you have a really tight, narrow spot, and yours coming down works great because you can see your countertop and you can see your stove. So what you're doing is working great. It all depends where you are. And Darby, yours is working great too with the two different things. Because you, let me see, when I broadcast, this is going into like more technical stuff here, but my cabinets are right here. And I can't put the laptop right there, or it's down here, it's going to be way too small. If I cannot put my laptop on my stove, if I'm cooking, because it's just a hazard. All right. And when I do the, if I'm using the oven, the humidity comes up from the oven, and that's just a no-go putting the camera over here. Plus then when I put the camera on the stove, the light underneath it, overpowers it, and I get washed out. Okay. It also, when you broadcast, I changed my lights in my kitchen. So the light right here is a bright white light. The bright white lights up here. That's a bright white light. And then the light underneath my stovetop here. The stove. Let me say, do it this way. The light underneath here is a bright white one too. All right. And then that way you can see it. Because when you use yellow lights, your food looks funky, y'all. So I learned that one like probably 4 years ago. Change the light bulbs. All right. And you can see how it's shining down on my head. Whereas if I was scoping over here without the light, I'm very, very dark. And plus then you're getting the light from the outside and it reflects on my glasses. So this is not the best one for me. Whereas over here, you get me, and I'm more center focused. All right. Just give me a little tips. All right. This is all done. Turn that off. It's going to be beeping at us. All right. So hopefully they found value in that. If you have any other questions, how to help you in your broadcast, we can always come in and help you say, all right, let's move this around. But it's finding the right spot for you in your kitchen and how your kitchen works with your camera and your laptop. Or your second device. And my second device is sort of kaput. I got to go get it like wiped out, because when I have a second device, I can actually go into Facebook and block that troll. Okay. The other day we had a troll in here that had 11 accounts. And after that broadcast, I went in and blocked every single one. And on Facebook business page, it's a public area. And so I can block them. I muted all the comments and I banned that person on the Facebook business page. All right. And the best thing about trolls, all right, trolls have to eat. All right. We all eat in the world. It is a necessity to eat. It is not a luxury. And I give people usually 3 strikes before they're out. All right. Because you know what? They're hurting inside, these people that are trolls. They just want attention. They don't have enough attention in their life. They are either bullied and they want to bully us. All right. But they all eat. And if I can, you know, help this person say, hey, I can make this at home. I can make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich at home. Or I can teach somebody how to flip an egg, which we did that a long time ago. We taught a lot of people how to flip eggs. And I've been doing, I can pump hard still on Periscope. You got two people. Thanks. I got two people. I don't even know how to, I can't even get into Periscope. So Periscope, I just broke it's, I'm not even sure if that's working or not, but I keep it on here. Okay. So
with people that are trolls, okay? Now, there are trolls that are mean and belligerent, and those need to go bye-bye. But we can meet them, and I, you know, I give you three strikes, and then three strikes, you're out, okay? And this is how what I used to do. People used to give me super hearts on Periscope. I used to give them the super heart back, okay? And you all are my stars, because without you, I'd be talking to myself in my kitchen, all right, and being very lonely. Yes, we are. Us broadcasters are lonely people, because that's why we come live, and we talk to all of you. So you all are my stars, all right? And then we have the triangle. We have the dreaded triangle. Three strikes, one, two, three, and then you're out the door, all right? Because everybody needs a second chance and to learn something new, all right? And if I can teach them, to use a different oil or to make something at home, then I've succeeded. Okay. I've helped that person. All right. Periscope still exists, says Mike. Hey, Mike. I don't know how you get on there. Mine kicks me out and takes me over to Twitter. There you go. Hello, Water Valley. Watermelon. The watermelon crawl. Remember that song? Wait, I forget how you can do the watermelon crawl way down south in July. There's a watermelon festival where you do the watermelon crawl. I don't know the words to it, but it goes something like that. There used to be a line dance to that. Maybe Aiden can do the watermelon dance. It was a line dance, Aiden. I used to do it. The watermelon. So anyway, that's, let's see. I'm going to go back. Yeah, that was crazy. I'm watching from Periscope, says Timmy. I put my laptop on the counter and run a webcam up inside of my cabinet. Now, that's a difference. I don't have any web cameras, and I'm a broke Pampered Chef person, and I don't buy anything. I mean, I'm like, I want another pair of shoes, another pair of sneakers, and I'm going to earn those shoes on my Pampered Chef team page with my upline. I'm going to earn all the $5 Amazon cards and get my shoes for free, okay, because I need a new pair for probably May, because I wear my sneakers out every 6 months. I've been wearing sneakers out. So it's time for a new pair of sneakers, y'all. So. And I want a skirt, but I'm like, I'm not buying that skirt. I don't have the money for it. So anyway, the web camera, no. And they actually told me that, Darby, to use a Bluetooth microphone. Like for me to use earphones on here, there's just no way. Bluetooth headphones, he said. Can you imagine me coming around here with headphones on with y'all? I like to hear my food cook, y'all. I just thought about that. I like to hear my food cook. Just got to show you. And I think the sound is fine. It doesn't have to be crystal clear. I think it's more of showing you how to cut stuff up, showing you the tools than it is anything. I got 7 messages. I'm behind here. If you drink, don't drive, do the watermelon crawl. Monkey, monkey, donkey, you got it. If you drink, don't drive, do the watermelon crawl. That's it. Mike, I see you on Periscope, says Demi. Hey, Watermelon, thank you for the Stay Safe Award. Hey, Hannah, how are you doing? Good idea. Sarah says, yeah. So, and another thing is, always have water or something around when you're broadcasting. And you can always tell me, say, Alexis, you need some water, because I talk too fast. And when I talk too fast, you're like, man, whoosh, whoosh. All right, I'm from the north. We talk really fast. But drinking water slows you down. And I'll show you this. Sarah Z, Sarah Sparkles, Hannah is saying hi to you over here on Hacks. Okay. So that's the difference. Just have water and it slows you down. All right. Know your triggers. Okay. And know if you're talking too fast, because you know when you're talking too fast, to drink some water, slow yourself down, gain your thoughts, and then keep on broadcasting. Okay. Because sometimes we all get close up. Hannah, I'm coming to your house and we're going to drink a glass of wine. I have to stay over then. So anyway, I'll just wipe myself to Hannah's house. It's going to make me tired, Hannah. Okay, glass of wine. Yeah, if it slows you down. I don't know what a glass of wine would do with me. Okay, Sarah says, hello, Hannah. Oh, you can see it. Yeah, Hannah can see the Facebook comments, but the Facebook people can't see the Haps comments. I got it. Yeah, sometimes it goes over my head. So, okay, Force Captain, hey, Space Force Captain, how you doing? Hi, what a funny profile picture you have. Is it really? Watermelon sugar high. Watermelon Sugar High. No, no, we're talking about the watermelon song. Do the watermelon crawl. I gotta clean that little package up right there. That's all the instructions from all my mom's frozen food from QVC, y'all. I just stuff them all in one. It needs to be cleaned up. Watermelon. Oh my God, don't start. That song is in my head since last night. Do the watermelon crawl. Oh wait, where's the words at that one? Somebody have the words here. If you drink, don't drive, do the watermelon crawl. Way down south. I think it's in Georgia. About the 4th of July. Let's see if Alexa knows that song. Alexa, do you know the watermelon crawl song?
Showing songs from your library or Prime Matching Watermelon Crawl. For more tracks, check out Amazon
Music. What's she going to give me?
Send it to TV. This might take a few seconds. Sorry, something went wrong.
Oh, shoot.
Please try again in a few minutes.
Oh, my goodness. She don't know. She don't know. No, this song is more hippies. Oh, hipper. I'll trigger a migraine. No, trigger migraines. Yeah, the wine would trigger a migraine. The wine would. Although I did take a little shot of that wild turkey a while back, and oh my gosh, it burned all the way down. I felt that alcohol going, and it went bang, and it was burning down there. I'm like, don't do that again, Alexis. You don't need any of that. I went right to bed after that. It's by Harry Styles, Watermelon Sugar. Oh, I don't know that one. What's the other one? What's the one by the Watermelon Crawl? Okay. Hey, Winky Wonky Donkey. Who sings that song? Man, I got enough of these here. And we just added two big ones, too. Look how big this thing is. This is almost as big as my head, y'all. This is the one. This is the big one I thought I had. And this is the small one. I like the small one. Maybe Alan Jackson. No, it wasn't Alan Jackson. I don't know her name. Alexa. Play the song, Way Down South.
Here's a station you might like.
Oh, jeez Louise. All 50s. Hound Dog. I think that's it. Born through a party in the county jail. Prison band was there, they were playing the whale. Man was jumping and the joint began to swing. You should have heard the lockdown jailbird singing. I'm better dancer than I am a singer. Alexa, stop. Jailhouse Rock. There's a Jailhouse Rock. It's Tracy Byrd. Okay. Alexa, sing the Watermelon Song by Tracy Byrd.
I couldn't find Watermelon Song by Tracy Byrd, but here is other music by Tracy Byrd.
This is it. We love those festivals here in the South. Drive, do the watermelon crawl. You had to turn on these things and all. I forget the name of the song. As soon as I see the feet work, I would probably go right into it. Crawl. Gallons of sweet red wine from the biggest watermelon on the vine.
the law. If you drink, don't drive. Do the watermelon crawl. Oh, this is a fun day today, y'all. That's a different decade. This is like the 90s. Early. This is 90s. This is a fun song. Hey, Bill. Come on, dance, Bill. Tony Dean. Watermelon crawl. 100 gallons of sweet red wine from the biggest watermelon on the vine. Lord, if you drink, don't drive. Do the watermelon crawl. Hey, Bill. Be nice, Tony. Watermelon crawl. All right, that made my day, y'all. We were going to be singing this song all day long. Ding, ding, ding. That was fun, y'all. We can't do it in a slow one now. Alexa, stop. Well, that was fun, y'all. We did the... You got this. Man, I tell you what. What are we going to make tomorrow? The watermelon crawl. You'll have to... Yeah, this is great. This is great. This is what broadcasting is all about. You can go on to YouTube and see Plop Plop Fizz Fizz and throw it into the thing. It's all done. Like, I could do that, like, you know, cut and take, and you get that all done. But you get personality on Haps or any broadcasting that's live. It was a great song, Darby. That's great. But you get the actual person, and you get to know them and their family. Hey, Winky Wonky, thanks. I got talent. I got no talent on that one. I got talent. I used to be quite good at country western dancing, okay, like partner dancing, two-step and swing. Like, I danced in the Super Bowl in 1996, the pregame show to Charlie Daniels Band. And I did a couple other little performances and stuff like that. So I would go out. I would dance at least six nights a week. I would have one day off, and that wasn't Sunday. It was probably like a Tuesday thing. We took off, and we didn't dance on Tuesdays. But we would go out and dance every single night of the week. Yeah, country western swing. Like, you know when people, when you watch the people on Dancing with the Stars, those type of moves, you know? And everybody was dancing all at the same time. It was so much fun. It was a little... club in Marietta, Georgia called Miss Kitty's, and I learned how to dance there, and I took dance lessons for about 6 months every Monday for at least 6 months, even could have been longer. And you would just go out. Mondays was learning day, and then you practice every day of the week, and you never said no to anyone that you would ask you to dance, okay? Because there's leads and follows, and I was a follower. Hello, Tina Thorm. How you doing? My active sponsor there. One of my five active sponsors, all right? So, so I would go out dancing. I had several different dance partners throughout my dance career before Bryce. This is all before Bryce. And we would go dancing a lot. We went up to Knoxville. It was on one of the CM country western music stations. We did a dance up there on that. But the biggest one was the Super Bowl. This was all before Bryce. It was fun. And I was like down to like I'm at 145 pounds right now. I was down to 119 pounds, y'all. I was like a little tiny thing. And the outfits that they gave us for the Olympics was about this big. This no lie, this little skirt was about this big, about this long. And it's the smallest outfit ever. But I fit into it way back. It was like 117 pounds. And the people that I was working with said, don't lose any more weight because you're looking a little too thin. And I was all muscle then, because we would go out and I would only have one beer per night. Like, you go to the bar and have that one beer and that would be it. Drink water the rest of it. I did have a dance partner, and his name is Mark, and we still communicate a lot. He's actually one of Bryce's godfathers, him and Bert. And we met
a very interesting way we met. But anyway, he was my dance partner at the time. He still is. I still call him my dance partner. You should dance again. Maybe you can dance for 3 or 5 minutes before everyone. I don't dance like I don't dance single. I dance with a dance partner. That's a thing. I like the male and female, or you know, the lead and the follows, and I'm a follower. And it's like keeping your arms up like this and your hands in somebody else's hands and doing that. I can do revolutions. You know how people spin? I would do like 20 revolutions and come out on the right foot. Or at this one bar, there was a pole and a banister, and it was enough room like this. And I used to spin through that bar all the time. I was thinking I'm going to hit myself on that bar, but you just spin. And the people that learned how to dance at Miss Kitty's in Georgia, in Marietta, Georgia, were known for spinning, all right? Whereas Texas, they didn't spin as much. And Maryland, I went up and danced in Maryland. They weren't spinners. And they're like, oh, where did you learn how to spin like that? It's just like an ice skating figure. You get used to that blurriness, and you come out on the right foot. Tango, yeah, I didn't do the tango. Ballroom dancing would be great. I would need a guy, and if I ever started dancing, that would be like a really good bonus if the person was a dancer or wanted to learn how to dance, but they need to have a little like movement in them. I've been in with people who are like this, like dancing. That's it. You know, like, oh, no. You have to like be moving. You also need to be in condition when you dance, because like it takes your breath away on it. Elvira, my heart's on fire for Elvira. Elvira. What was the guy? I had his name on it. He used to come and sing at the bar in he was from Marietta, Georgia. Not George Strait, the other guy. I forgot his name. But anyway, he used to come and sing in the bar all the time. Great. Actually, yeah, it does. And if anybody wants to date me and they're a dancer, I'm like, oh, I'm right there, y'all. Let's just go take some dance lessons. Let's go out to the ballroom or wherever. Just go dance somewhere. Because if you have a partner, you can dance. Now, Aiden does line dancing. Line dancing is by yourself. You just do the same thing. You move, you know, you're just moving like this. But when you interact with somebody and you're dancing with them with your hands and doing stuff and doing ducks and turns and all the tricks that go with dancing, it is so much fun. It was so much fun. That was before Bryce. When I had Bryce, I lost the desire of dancing and stuff like that, but it's coming back. I would still, if somebody out here said, hey, I would love to learn how to dance with you, I'm like, yes. I'd be like, I'll be all right into it. You know, it is great exercise. It just motivates you, you know, and the different songs that come on. I don't even know the names of the words. Like, I just go by the music. And I would dip. Let me see. We did East Coast Swing. There's a difference on West Coast Swing. That came in later. My dance partner never learned West Coast Swing, but I do know West Coast Swing, and that's more popular now. So yeah, two-step, East Coast, West Coast, cha-cha, the polka, and that's just like a 1, 2, 3, two. And you go for it. You just do the same moves. It's just different footwork on it. Does Bryce like to dance? Ah, winky wonky. You know, when we were up in Pennsylvania, there was a night where it was family night and it was dancing night. And we actually have our picture. If you ever Google my name, and that you'll see Bryce and I dancing. I have dark hair at that time, but I took him dancing, and he is a pretty good dancer. His dad was a good dancer too. So Bryce should be able to dance. I'm frozen again on my screen right here. So Bryce likes to dance. At least that's what I hear. Anyway, my screen is frozen. So let me see. There we go. We're back. Let me put the charger back in because my battery is going down here. But yeah. I dance with my broom, says Gina Jen. You can dance with your broom. Dance with your broom, everyone, you know? Let's see. I used to Texas two-step, says Darby, and line dance years ago. Yeah, that was years ago with me, too, when I was like, what, 20 years ago? It would be 20 years ago, because Bryce is 19. It'll be 20 this year. So 20 years ago, 38. So I started learning how to dance probably between 32. No, 28, between 28 and 38, say. 28 to 38. For about 10 years, I danced. About 10 years. So, and it was a lot of fun. So that's something that you don't get when you watched a Plop Plop Fizz Fizz broadcast on we're on an hour and a half. Man, I'm just going to town here. I got to go to the post office too. So if anybody wants a catalog and going to the post office, reach out to me. Send me your email or your a mailing address, and I'll send you a catalog. Otherwise, there's a virtual catalog in my profile, and I'll put that over here. All right, that was a lot of fun. Now I got to probably heat up my super. Hopefully, it's ready to go. Let me see. I have Boot Scoot and Boogie. I love that song. Boot Scoot Boogie. Dosey do da da da. Boot Scoot Boogie. That's another part of a song. You got some moves. Now I used to, not anymore. Hubby and I were planning to take dance lessons for a cruise, then pandemic hit. Yeah, that's a bummer thing. But just move your furniture around a little bit, Hannah. I know where Hannah lives, y'all. So anyway, just move your furniture around and you know, learn it online. You can still learn it. Put the music on Friday night instead of like sitting around. Just like, hey, let's learn how to do this, you know. And as long as your both feet are going, you're doing great. Okay, is the binder done? The blender. Yeah, the blender was done a while ago. Blender's done all a while ago. Oh, and it's cleaned too. It's cleaned. It's all cleaned on us too. So let's see. Oh, it's nice that it's like room temp now. Still missing something. I don't know what it is. Maybe a little more salt. Remember, we didn't put that much salt in there. Let's put the salt in. All right. But it tastes great. And this is good for you because all it is veggies on here, okay? Could be the salt. Let's let it blend in there. Mm-hmm. YouTube teaches you everything. When Bryce was younger, I would say, Bryce, can you help me? He goes, well, why don't you YouTube it? So now I say, YouTube it, Bryce. My little kid would say, did you YouTube it? And at one time I was trying to look at how to refill a staple gun. And I'm like, how do you open this thing? And I YouTubed it, and I figured out how to refill my staple gun by YouTubing it. So you can YouTube everything, all right? I want to thank everybody for coming in and spending part of your time. Hopefully you had fun today on the broadcast and that you'll come back and visit and learn something new on cooking. Thank God for Google, not news. Oh, my gosh. I don't even watch TV unless my mom has it on. I sit out there, but she watches, like, reruns of The Waltons and Matlock. What does she have on now? Oh, she has Little House on the Prairie on now. So, hey, Darby, thanks for coming in, all right? And hopefully, if you are interested in any of the Pampered Chef, I am a Pampered Chef consultant, and it is my full-time job, all right? And I need some hosts, people that just want to get some Pampered Chef for free or discounts, okay? It doesn't cost you anything. I send you a couple catalogs. You can even do a catalog show and just get a couple catalogs. And this month is a really good month to host because the host rewards, once you get to $200, you get anything in the catalog for 60% off. So you can get the blender right there for $112 this month in April. When you host the show, get it for $112. It's well worth its investment, okay? Thanks, Demi. Okay, that's cool. And all the other stuff, if you want the grill, I got the grill. I didn't even unbox it yet. I have still to figure out where I'm going to put it, y'all. But anyway, all the stuff. Cold brew coffee pitcher makes great Mother's Day presents. There's a lot of things coming up. So if you say, oh, I have all that, you know, well, think of somebody that might want to have it for like Mother's Day, for Administration Day, Nurses Day, Teacher Appreciation, the bus driver. All these people, they would really appreciate it. Every single time that they bring out like the Coramore or the cold brew pitcher, they'll say, oh, Johnny's mom gave me this. Or, oh, that nice couple gave me this idea. I know there's this one, she was a broadcaster and she was on Periscope and I think she passed away. I never heard back from her, but she had cancer. And the last I heard from her, she had hosted a show. And she got the cold brew coffee pitcher for the nurse that was in charge, and gave her the cold brew coffee pitcher. And that's like memories from me as a business. Now, can any of your businesses where you purchased on know why you bought that? All right. Like, I know Sarah up in Boston, I hope you shouldn't mind talking about her, but her parents are wanting a stone bar pan. And so she's going to purchase the stone bar pan. So that's really cool. So she knows like who she got it from. She saw me cook on it. So she baked him. And so I know that she's going to give it to her parents. Isn't that sweet? All right. I can't find your video doing fluffy egg. Can we do something for a demo? Yeah, I can do a fluffy egg. I love doing the fluffy egg, y'all.
the fluffy egg. The first one here that I did on Periscope didn't come out as good, or on Haps here. If you scroll to my very first broadcast here on Haps, it was the fluffy egg. However, I kept it in there too long and it deflated on me. Okay, so it wasn't too fluffy. It was fluffy, but not fluffy like I like it. And I did a couple other ones since then, but we can do a fluffy egg tomorrow. I can do a fluffy egg. I also like, I've been doing eggs with ricotta cheese, and I put it on the tortilla, and I put the tortilla with the cottage cheese, and I put my egg in my 10-inch pound, and then I put that on top, and then I've been learning how to flip tortilla with the egg in the bottom, flip the whole thing in the 10-inch pan. I've been learning that off screen without y'all, okay? So, oh, you're welcome. Good to see you, Tina. Wholesomeness. Thank you. Thank you. You're welcome. All right. Let's see. Please teach me, Demi. Okay. That sounds, yeah. Okay. So the fluffy egg, you either need to whip up your eggs with a whisk, and it takes you like 10 minutes or so, and you're going to be tired doing it. All right. I use my whipped cream maker. The whipped cream maker, it's a Pamper Chef thing. They can make your own whipped cream in there. You can use a blender if you want to froth them up, I think. You can probably froth up your eggs in there. We can try that. I had never done it in there. I always use my whipped cream maker, and it takes about a minute, minute and a half to froth up my egg whites. And that's the whole key, is frothing up your egg whites so that they're nice and stiff. All right. Let's see. Captain Rehab, a fluffy Cooper. No, my Cooper is fluffy. He actually lost 2.5 pounds since he's been at the vet. Last week, they told me he lost 2.5 pounds. Good idea. So the whipped cream maker, that is the best thing. But there are other ways of getting eggs frothy. You can use your electric mixer, but you're going to be there forever doing that too. But it works. It works. But that egg whipper, minute and a half, you're all done, y'all. You can only do 2 eggs at a time. All right. So that's it for today. I don't even know. Let's leave it at the, let's do the last picture of, oh, I got to take you off the connection here. You're not going to come with me that way. All right, let's flip this around, and we'll do the last shot of the blender, because that's what we were making, okay? And we made our soup. Here's my soup. It's a little darker than normal, but I think it's because I put in the veggie, super veggies, and I also put in the peels from the apple, okay? So take care, everybody. I'll see you all tomorrow right around 12:30, okay? Probably around 12:30-ish, okay? And I got to get to the post office now. So thanks for coming in, and have a great Tuesday, y'all. Okay. Bye. Yeah. I know. I always do the, I love my egg whipper. Yeah. The egg whipper, the egg whipper, and the whipped cream maker. Okay. All right. Talk to y'all next time. Have a great Tuesday. I'll see you in somebody else's broadcast. Bye.